Good afternoon, Father Henry Carr staff, teachers, parents, family and friends, and most importantly to the graduating class of 2019. Today is June 27, 2019, and we are on a graduation schedule. Please stop what you're doing and listen up for your valedictorian announcement. Today we embark on a new adventure filled with mystery and wonder. And today, we become more accountable and have more control of our future. Emphasis on the word control. See, that word holds so much power in creating such an impactful influence on the human mind, body, and spirit. But I do believe that each and every single one of you not only have the potential, but the power to change the world. Starts with being a more responsible and caring sister, brother, son, or daughter. A change to the system by excelling in our field of study after high school, and a change that molds us into becoming the best version of ourselves. See, these new challenges we will face in the future are all unknown, but we must believe in the unknown, because that belief will lead each and every single one of us in achieving our own versions of success. But that's in the future, and this is the present. So allow me to introduce myself. My name is Brian Osei-Boate. And it is an honor to be standing here representing the Father Henry Carr class of 2019 at this year's graduation ceremony. So now allow me to take you down memory lane. It all started 4 years ago. It was 4 years ago in grade 9 we began a new adventure together in a new environment. See, some people we recognized back from elementary, and for others, it was our first time meeting each other. But the goal was not just to make new friends, it was to find another family. See, the first day of high school felt like it was yesterday, walking through the doors of the unknown and looking for an opportunity. An opportunity to show a new group of people how amazing we are, whether that was academically, physically, or artistically. Because we have all done something special to offer to Father Henry Carr. See, compared to elementary, high school has said many new things. From the late starts to the food at the cafeteria, high school was looking like everything that we had hoped for and saw on TV, except there wasn't a musical in 5 minutes. See, grade 9 was also the year we began to find our true identity while connecting with the people that will soon become our family. It was the start of a long but fun journey ahead that will mold us into the agents of change that we want to see in the world. Now fast forward to grade 10, and there's no excuse for freshman mistakes. See, coming up many ups and downs from our first year experience of high school, grade 10 was the year to rewrite those wrongs. Once again, we had the opportunity to bounce back from the defeats of our past, rewire our brain, and claim what is ours. Although the school was getting harder, we adjusted. All kinds of obstacles like Instagram, Snapchat, and procrastination were all of our enemies of progress, but we prevailed. Grade 10 was a learning curve for all of us as we slowly became more comfortable with the path we were on as we reached the halfway point of our high school career. Then came grade 11. See, this was part of the journey where high school got turned up a notch. Math was now called functions. Functions of what? And somehow science had 3 babies called chemistry, biology, and physics, and we had to take care of them. And then, although it seemed like our world was turning upside down, grade 11 gave us something so special, so beautiful. See, ladies and gentlemen, I'm talking about stairs. That was the time where we could do whatever we want and not go to class. See, I'm talking about reviewing our notes, and get this, doing homework at school. See, that kind of privilege we had needs a party. And I'm not talking about no regular party, but a semi-formal party. Because thanks to Mr. Yumi and our GPP leadership class, in 2017, Father Henry Carr had its first semi-formal in almost 10 years. our final year of high school. And now we're in grade 12. See, the expectations for us got increasingly higher and almost impossible as we had to answer the most powerful question of them all. So, what? Well, you know what? I figured it out. And if you don't believe me, I have the citations to prove it. But with all the jokes aside, this was the year where all of our high school lessons and blessings were shown. From grade 9 through 11, we laid the foundation of who we are, and grade 12 was the time to climb our own pillars of success. We had to decide whether university, college, or the workplace was our calling, and with a lot of guidance from our guidance counselor, Mrs. Deanna Topolis, we were able to stay on the right path no matter how many times we stressed her out by changing our courses. See, we had so many memories throughout this year, from representing and giving it our all in FHC sports, clubs, car tracks, and field trips, like going to Wanakita and leading the future of FHC with Ms. Hensley and Mr. Marquezin. Yeah. This year lived up to the expectations that we all had in mind. And just last week, we had our Enchanted Garden theme prom. That was one of the last times we'll be together as one. So we decided to go out with a bang. Our girls came looking even more beautiful. Ladies on the rise, while our guys came with all the swag and confidence, like men of distinction. Men of distinction. Trust 15 is back in better than ever, and room 218 from 3:30 to 6 p.m. And if anyone has any questions, go for the grade 12 Brian and Tevin. Because of many people in our lives, our futures are now clear. So we should give thanks to our family and our fellow sisters and brothers. The sacrifices you made for us helped us get through any time we suffered. So thank you to those who couldn't make it to our grad, as you are in our hearts and in our souls. You are the ones that helped us get here and helped make us all whole. And thank you to our family for raising us, and I hope we made you proud. You taught us not to be wallflowers, but to stand out in a crowd. And stand out we will with our new grad wear. Renee and Sosa gave us clothing that made us confident while many others stared. And looking through the halls were Stephanie and Marvin. You taught us not to be hungry for success, but to be started. See, high school gave us opportunity to shine, to prove to everyone that doubted that this is our time. Whether we were leaders with Radaganda or Castronovo, we brought the energy like the Cypress with Miss Ignoto. And God will bring all the blessings as our guardian angel. Lord, that I might see is a mantra that will keep us all faithful. So thank you to Miss Julianne Lee with helping me make dramatic memories with the gift of poetry. But I also have to give a shout out to Mr. McLaughlin and Mr. Maroli. No matter where we go, we will always be your babies. Yeah. And to the graduates, from the early mornings to the late nights, your resilience and determination to get through this four-year grind we call high school is nothing but admirable. And I wish you nothing but success in all your future endeavors. See, a wise Iron Man once said that part of the journey is the end. But quite frankly, this is just the beginning. The beginning of new memories and opportunities that will last a lifetime. And now, we shall walk into the sunset as we are kings and queens in the making, ready to claim our throne. Ladies and gentlemen, Father Henry Carr's graduating class of 2019, thank you and God bless.